And I'm ballin' in the Golden State, I think I'm Chris Mullin. Been hearing disrespect from all these children that I'm sonnin'. Fool, I've been putting work in and you ain't been putting none in. So, thinking hating on me might just get you something. Are you dumb and you just wanna start some shit up off of nothing? Look, I don't get it, you haters are pathetic. See, another man's success should only hurt you if you let it. I know you like my style and my image and aesthetic. How I put my plans in motion, that's kinetic. You get it? Look, hating on me, bro, that shit will get you nowhere. Your bitch checked into my show on her Foursquare. They like how he gets them hoes, though it's no fair. But hard work is paying big and we don't need to go.
Yo, what is up, guys? Phasm here. And today what I got for you guys is a 210-2 on the map Turbine with the Scar H with that UK Punk camo. You guys probably have seen this on the Doom Clan channel. But anyways, the gameplay in today's commentary is going to be quite irrelevant, because today I'm going to be talking to you guys how I managed to do this. Yeah. So anyways, a little disclaimer first. I'm not the best storyteller, and you know, so you guys are just going to have to listen really closely and kind of focus on what I'm saying, because the whole story is kind of confusing and hard to understand. But I'll get right into it anyway, because I want you guys to understand what happened and let you guys know what goes on in my personal life as well as my YouTube life. So, this happened yesterday, and yesterday was, you know, not that good of a day, because just, for one, I totaled a car, and then today, me and my girlfriend broke up, but that was more of a mutual thing, and that's not really bringing me down too much, but that's just a side story. So back to the main story. Yesterday was an early out day in my school, so we get out at around 12:30 instead of our usual 2:05. So that's always nice. So you know, of course, I decided to go get some lunch with friends. And yesterday was actually the first day that I had my keys back in my pocket. I had my car taken away until yesterday from my first speeding ticket. So yeah, long story short, the day I got my car back, I totaled it. So that's pretty shitty. But alright, now we're going to get into the story of how I managed to total it. So I was, we had just gotten lunch with my friend, and we took it back to his house and ate it. And we finished that up, and I had to go to my orthodontist appointment. So I hopped in my car, and you know, was leaving his neighborhood, took a right turn out of his neighborhood, and then ahead of me there were three cars. You know, it was a stop sign, so I pulled out on the stop sign, and there were three cars ahead of me. I pulled out right behind a Silverado. I found my gap, you know, pressed the gas, turned right out, and I was on the road. We were in the middle of a school zone, so the lights were flashing, the school was still in session, so we still had to abide by the rules, so we were all going about 20 miles per hour. And then, as soon as we started getting out of the school zone, you know, it was the end of the school zone, and we were at about 30 miles per hour. There were three cars ahead of me, like I mentioned earlier, and the very first car, you know, the guy that was leading the way in the little section of three cars that was in front of me, he decides to slam on his brakes and take a sharp left turn. I'm assuming that he, you know, didn't know his turn was coming up so fast or something like that, but not long story short, anyway, he just ended up slamming on his brakes and taking a sharp left turn, and that just started up a big bad chain reaction. And the guy after him, which this is the second guy in front of me, he slammed on his brakes and came to a complete stop. So the first guy took a sharp left turn and slammed on his brakes, and then the second guy slammed on his brakes and came to a complete stop. And now we're back to the first guy in front of me. This guy was driving a big old jacked up Chevrolet Silverado with a nice old trailer hitch on the back, and it's actually a sick looking truck. But anyways, he had to slam on his brakes as well. And because it was such a big jacked up truck, I had no idea about the guy that had taken the sharp left turn or the guy that had slammed on his brakes. So all I saw was the Silverado slam on his brakes, and I had no time to react. I did slam on my brakes, but I was not able to slow down fast enough, and I rear-ended the shit out of him. I just crammed right into him, and it was a pretty intense moment. I was shaking a lot right after it. The first thing I did was grab my phone and send my parents this message right here. And if you notice the language I'm using, my dad is a pastor, so that is not the best language to be using when you have the pastor as a father. But that's how I was feeling pretty much. And you see how I say, all right, going to my orthodontist appointment, and then all of a sudden, boom, and that was that. So that's that story on how I ended up totaling my car. And the cop was a pretty big douchebag about it, a pretty big dick. He, you know, I was trying to, according to the law, it's my fault, and I understand why it's my fault, because I'm the only one who ended up hitting a car, and it's just, it's hard for me to wrap my mind around that, because honestly, there was nothing I really could do. All I saw was brake lights, and I had very minimal time to react, and I put a valiant effort, you know. I slammed on my brakes, I just wasn't able to stop in time. And I was trying to explain myself to the cop, but all the cop kept saying was, "Oh, did you hit the car in front of you?" And I was like, "Yeah, but," and I kept trying to explain myself, and he just kept cutting me off. "Oh, but you hit the car, right?" "Yeah, you hit the car in front of you. You hit the car. That's all he cared about. So I ended up getting a $166 careless driving ticket, which is stupid because I wasn't even driving careless. I wasn't texting. I wasn't swerving down the road. I wasn't being reckless or careless or any of those adjectives. I was just simply driving normal and did not have time to react. But I mean, it's over now. I can't do anything to change my consequences from that. And I mean, I got 4 points on my license, and it blows really bad because I just went through this with my speeding ticket, you know? I had to take a driver's class, to get the points off of my license, because in Florida, there is a point system for, it's like the consequences for, you know, crashing and speeding and just disobeying traffic laws. You get a point system on your license. Being 16, like I am, and being a new driver, if I get 6 points, they revoke my license in the state of Florida, and I have 4 points. And I got 4 points for my speeding ticket as well, but I was able to take the class and get the points off my license. But since I took the class so recently, I can't take it again until 1 year from the date you took it the first time. So I have 11 months where I'm going to have 4 points on my license, which, thinking about that and allowing that to sink in really kind of is awful, because that's gonna screw me over, you know, for my future. And if I make any more mistakes, my license could be gone for the whole time I'm in Florida. So I'm gonna have to be hella careful when I'm driving. And God, just thinking about that is really awful, because, you know, we all have to drive. We all have places to go, things to do, places to be, and it's gonna be a change to my future. And if you guys drive, I'm not sure how many of you guys of my subscribers are driving age. Just be extra careful, please, and pay attention 400% of the time, because every time you get into the car, it's a life or death situation. If I had been going faster, I could have easily died. I mean, it wasn't that close to being a fatal collision, because we were only going 30 miles per hour, and I mean, the front end of my car, you can tell, is pretty messed up, but I wasn't really harmed at all. The airbag went off, and it burned my arm a little bit, my forearm. Not like a flame burn, but like, you know, when you get a rug burn. That happened on my arm, and then my neck hurts today because, you know, from the whiplash, my neck is a little sore, and my chest was hurting yesterday from the impact of the airbag. But that's about it for, you know, pain. Nothing serious, nothing too bad. I pretty much walked away without a scratch, which is quite a, you know, a miracle, to be honest. I mean, I could have ended up a lot worse, especially with a ginormous Chevy Silverado. And for future car options, I'm still looking at cars right now, and I've been researching a lot of cars, because if the car is totaled, which I'm about 99% it is totaled, the insurance, the insurance adjuster will come out and look at it and tell us how much it will give us for the car. I'm predicting about between 9 and 10 grand. So that's the money to work with for a new car. I'm not, you know, I don't really know what I'm looking to get just yet. I do want a car that has good gas mileage, because that's really important to me, because I'm going to college next year, and I have to, you know, obviously drive to the campus. And the campus is like 40 minutes away, and if I do that on the daily, I don't want to be, you know, paying a shit ton of money for gas. So I still gotta figure everything out. I do like the idea of me driving a truck. I've been looking at quite a few trucks. We have a nice little 97 Ford Ranger stick shift that I like a lot. It has, you know, built-in a sub box and a nice sub and aftermarket speakers, aftermarket stereo, and things like that. And that would get about 20 miles to the gallon. So not amazing gas mileage, but better than some of the options on the market. The reason I like the truck is because, you know, just, you know, sturdy trucks are, they're just beasts. And my mom wants me to get a truck because, looking at his car, the guy that I hit here, I'll flash up a picture of that he posted on Instagram. There is a picture of his car, and, or not his car, his truck, his monster of a truck. That's about it, guys. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Leave some comments below of any vehicles that you know that would suit me well. Maybe a truck with good gas mileage and safety, or you know, a mid-sized car that has great gas mileage and is actually pretty safe. So anyways, my name is Phasm. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Like I mentioned, I'm watching this video over the commentary or comment. I don't even know what I'm trying to say, but anyways, hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. My final score line was 210-2, and just please be careful when you drive or when you enter any kind of vehicle, and just use this as kind of future reference for you guys. No one should have to go through that. It's a terrible experience, and I'm still shaking up from it today, and I'm not sure what's going to come in the future. I'm a little nervous about what's going to happen. But I guess we'll just leave it up to God and, you know, see what happens. So my name is Phasm. Hopefully you enjoyed the video, and I'm out. Peace.